Hi, I'm Erin Gardiner.
And I'm James Gardiner. Theater at Mason would like to thank the Friends of Theater for their ongoing support of our programs, especially their support of scholarships for our students.
Please consider becoming a friend. You can join and give by logging onto our website and click on Give.
Now settle back and enjoy.
About incredible things. Then you look and suddenly you have wings. You can fly. You can fly. But first you dream. First you dream about remarkable times. Close your eyes and see how your spirit climbs. You can fly, you can soar, feel the wind, hear it roar.
High above the rooftops, there's a barn, there's a field of corn. In that little white house where another you was born. Isn't it fine? Isn't it fair? Being up here, looking down there.
Everyone's noticed the change in me, the heartening, startling change in me.
No longer depressed, I'm looking my best and totally in control.
Though grim and obsessively sad was I, and never organically glad was I. Now life is the berries and cherries invaded my bowl. Harvey and the children are relieved.
My girlfriend said I'm not to be believed.
And my secret isn't diet, drugs, or pills. I've simply found a new routine to banish all my coffee in the morning,
my brandy in the evening,
and Arthur in the afternoon. I don't have any gray days since I've my matinee days
with Arthur in the afternoon.
He has a small apartment in the center of town.
But I gun my Hyundai and I hurry on down to hear the banister squeak
and the waterbed slide. So you can keep your crystal to heat up someone's pistol. But this kid's it's in tune because she's got Arthur.
That's right, I said Arthur.
There's nothing like Arthur
in the afternoon.
Shirley MacLaine, dear.
I found all that it pained, dear.
I'd rather have Arthur in the afternoon. They say that love is better with the stars in the sky, but not for Arthur and me.
We start loving when the sun is high, from a quarter to two to a quarter to three.
So don't sit there and glower. Just pick another hour for your round trip to the moon. You gotta try Arthur. He's listed as Arthur. I recommend Arthur in the afternoon. Hello, Arthur. Got a little headache. Oh, my nerves are worn a little thin. I was wondering if you had an opening, and if you did, could you squeeze me in? You do? A quarter to two.
Well, I'm all ready to go to town. I'm gonna rev my motor and get on down.
Shopping cart out and go sing away your heart out. But there's no sun, sweet prune, as healthy as Arthur. Oh, that animal Arthur, get bitten by Arthur in the afternoon.
See, we can make it long as a anything, anywhere, anytime.
Thank you. heartache and hurt are no longer a part of the sea. Isn't this better the way it should be? Better for him, much better for him, and oh, so much better for me. Maybe this time.
Tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at Five Riverside. Her name is Shirley DeVore. And she's traveled around the world to meet the guy next door. Well, there was trouble inside apartment 29E. Cause Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said we'd hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse. But you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells. You gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them tingling. You gotta ring them bells.
Well, Shirley was 31, which she was loath to admit. And she had never been loved, which didn't thrill her a bit. And so she sat and she thought for hours on end. And said, I'll go to Chase Manhattan where I got me a friend. And so she borrowed a thou and called TWA. And told her mother and dad that she was up and away.
I'm gonna travel the continent a month, maybe two. And haul me home a huzz if it's the last thing I do. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells. You gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them bells.
The kind of a town where you'll be likely to fall, and all the Tony Conoscenti find the Balkans a ball.
You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them bells.
She went to Dubrovnik, and the very first day she met a guy on the beach that took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight and quite a beautiful scene. She said,
"My name is Charles Devoir."
He said,
"I'm Norm Saperstein."
She said, "Are you from New York?" He said,
"That can't be denied. I got a swell junior 3 at number 5 Riverside."
Five Riverside Drive? In New York? 5? That's where I live. Can you believe this? 5? Are you sure? As if that wasn't enough, poor Shirley thought she'd gone deaf when he told her his apartment there was 29F. He was F, and they had not even met
until she traveled the world to Yugoslavia. Yet
he'd always been right next door, and she would never have known.
She hadn't tried Dubrovnik, she might still be alone.
Well, there's a moral to learn from little Shirley DeVore, who had to borrow door. You girls who live in apartments, don't stare at the wall.
Open up the door
and hurry out in the hall.
Ring them bells, come on, ring them bells. Make them sing, ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them sing.
Of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango. Pop.
6. Squish.
Cicero.
Lip shits. Pop.
6. Squish.
Cicero.
Lip shits.
Pop. 6. Squish.
People have those little habits that get you down. Like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew. Pop. So I come home from work one day, and I'm really irritated. I'm looking for a little bit of sympathy, but there's Bernie. Laying on the couch, drinking a beer, and chewing. No, not chewing. Popping. So I said to him, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired 2 warning shots into his head.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have heard it, I bet you would have done the same.
I met Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago, and he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd mix him a drink, and we'd have dinner. Well, it was like heaven in 2.5 rooms until I found out. Single, he told me. Single my ass. Not only was he married, oh no, he had 6 wives. One of those Mormons, you know. So that night when he came home, I mixed him his drink as usual. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic.
He had it coming,
pop, 6,
he had it coming,
Cicero,
he took a flower,
pop, 6,
and it was
hot,
Cicero,
and
then
he
kitchen, carving up the chicken for dinner, minding my own business. And in storms my husband Wilbur in a jealous rage. "You been screwing the milkman," he says. He was crazy. And he kept on screaming, "You been screwing the milkman!" And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times!
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you you would have done the same.
Meet, kiedyś genit, ast mun jak oja I reśak hum ma fokta afirinit. In megle shokta ma fayet. Dilemigas, in our tats lan by yok, nay, to don. Vert munja Uncle Sam oi in to them. Pravatam, a reno shagin meg me rasi, they never aired to take me.
Yeah, but did you do it?
Not guilty.
My sister Veronica and I had this double act, and my husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now for the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks all in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, splits, spread eagles, flip-flops, backflips, one right after the other. Well, this one night we were in Cicero, the three of us, rooming, boozing, having a few laughs, and we ran out of ice, so I went out to get some. I come back, open the door, and there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17, the spread eagle. Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. Wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They had it coming.
More than I could possibly say. He was a real artistic guy. Sensitive. A painter. But he was trouble. He was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and on the way he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you can say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
The dirty bomb, 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 bomb. The dirty bomb, 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 bomb.
They had it coming.
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 All along.
Because
if they use us,
they use us,
and they abuse us,
and they abuse us,
how could you tell us that we were wrong? He had it coming.
He had it coming.
He had it coming.
He had it coming.
Number 17, the spread eagle.
Artistic differences.
I bet you would have done the
Bye.
Up the box and hand.
Taryn.
Hi, Dima. I wish I could see you in person.
Yeah, me too. Hey, you know what we can do?
What?
Sing a virtual duet?
Great.
And in this duet, you get to play my mother. What?
Fine.
We're the seniors, so it just kind of makes sense.
You were a terrible daughter.
Well, you are a horrible mother.
I can't even believe we're related. We have nothing in common.
That's not true. Nope. I hate Uncle Fausto.
God, me too. I hate growing older.
Boy, am I with you.
So you don't have to be a professor to see the apple doesn't fall very far from the tree.
I hate doing dishes. All that grease.
I hate Mrs. Carlucci.
May she rest in peace.
There's more than a few things on which we agree.
The apple doesn't fall very far. Oh,
the apple doesn't fall very far.
sing me a happy song about robins in spring. Sing me a happy song with a happy ending. Some cheerful roundelay about catching the ring. Sing happy.
Sing me a sonnet all about rolling in gold. Some happy melody about rainbows blending. Nothing with phrases saying you're out in the cold.
Some old ballad all about two eyes shining. It can't be loud enough for a moment too soon. Sing happy.
No need reminding me how it all fell apart.
I need no lyrics singing of stormy weather.
There's quite enough for
spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York.
These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step
the hill, top of the heap.
My little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York.
If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. To you, New York.
that's